Have you heard the story of the old pop goat who came from far and far, in a little town in Kerry where goats don't go no more? It's about a man named Dillon who cursed throughout the week, and how he was digging spuds one day when the goat to him would speak.
Are you digging him, Dillon? Are you digging him deep? Are you piling him, Dillon, in a great big heap?
I've been digging them, says Dillon, enough to fill a boat. I'd be digging more if it wasn't for you,
the great big ugly goat.
Now that goat was stealing Dillon's spuds for 20 years or more, and every time he saw him, Dillon cursed and raged and swore. He caught him in his teddy pad one sunny Sabbath day, and as his curses lit the sky, the goat looked up to say,
are you digging him, Dillon? Are you digging him deep? Are you piling him, Dillon, in a great big heap?
I've been digging them, says Dillon, enough to fill a boat. I'd be digging them more if it wasn't for you,
your great big ugly goat.
By when he heard old Dillon curse, ah, the goats and the spuds and the Lord above for making all things worse. To hush the Lord in heaven on his way to Mass that day, as he stood behind the old shady branch, the good priest hid his say.
Are you digging him, Dillon? Are you digging him deep? Are you piling him, Dillon, in a great big heap?
I've been digging them, says Dillon, enough to fill a boat. I'd be digging them more if it wasn't for you,
your great big ugly goat.
You could never tell Dillon was the priest that spoke to stop his blasphemy, as he stood behind the old shady branch where Dillon couldn't see. And to this day in Kerry, in the town of Farran Ford, they still believe 'twas the goat that spoke whenever Dillon swore.
Are you digging him, Dillon? Are you digging him deep? Are you piling him, Dillon, in a great big heap?
I've been digging them, says Dillon, enough to fill a boat.